Business as usual in the ice ball.
John Kudrowski is no stranger to Mount Qomolangma, Mount Everest to Westerners. The Colorado climber and guide has summited this nearly 8,849-meter behemoth twice and is poised to do it again in the next week or so.
I just love to come back here because they're the highest mountains in the world. They're just so beautiful. And I just feel lucky to have the health and youth, sort of, to still climb.
June 26th in the morning. After a long climb through the night.
Back in 2014, John dragged me to the summit of Africa's Mount Kilimanjaro. Now he hopes to put a client on top of this mountain in what's been an unusual year, even for this forbidding place. Qomolangma was closed last year because of the pandemic. The current COVID-19 outbreak in Nepal, which shares this mountain with China, has put climbers on edge.
There's been a lot of infections, so there's a lot of people that are in desperate need of healthcare and vaccines, and so it's a similar situation to what we had in the U.S. 6 months ago or 8 months ago, and it's not good.
These coronavirus cases may be tied in part to Nepal's decision to issue a record number of climbing permits. 2020's lack of activity on the mountain was a financial disaster for the country.
They depend heavily upon the tourists, the trekkers, and the mountaineers. And that brings much needed money, but of course, in a pandemic, it also brings risk.
Even more risk than normal. Climbers have always been a gregarious bunch.
But now I see like many groups are putting some line to not to cross. They said, please do not cross for the COVID-19 situation.
Our team put signs up around our dining tents and around our main tents just to say, look, it's COVID. Outside visitors aren't welcome.
Nepal now requires climbers to submit COVID-19 tests and ask them to give their used oxygen cylinders to local hospitals once their trips are over. But some expeditions have been scrapped, and China has closed its side of the mountain for health reasons. Jim Davidson, whose new book chronicles his escape from a deadly avalanche here in 2015 and a successful summit 2 years later, says patience and resilience are key.
Because we're going to have up days and down days. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to sit at the base of the mountain and wait for the weather to clear, or to stay locked in your house for 15 months waiting for the pandemic to clear.
In fact, Kudrowski is waiting for harsh weather to subside before he begins his four-day journey up. After a recent remeasurement by Chinese and Nepalese surveyors, Qomolangma was determined to be slightly taller than thought before, making conquering it an even more impressive feat for those who have the passion and are truly committed.
It's great to see climbers here again.
Hendrik Sybrandy, CGTN, Denver.